To try to understand Krishna as Rishikesha. So Rishikesha Krishna began to love that he is my friend, constant associate, and such weakness. He first of all was enthusiastic to ask me to take his chariot, Senaya Rubhar Madhya. Now Vishidantam, now he is lamenting. So we are all fools like that. Arjuna is not fool. Arjuna has been described as Burakrishna. How he can be fool? But he is playing the part of fool. If he does not play the part of a fool, how this Bhagavad-gita will come from the mouth of Sri Krishna? And because he is devotee, he is perfectly playing in such a way that Krishna is giving instruction. So, perfect teacher and the perfect disciple. Arjuna. We have to learn from them. Our position, Arjuna is representing just like ordinary man like us. And Krishna is Rishikesha giving his advice. Perfect advice. If you read Bhagavad-gita in the spirit of understanding, like Arjuna, the perfect disciple, and if you accept the advice and instruction of Krishna, the perfect teacher, then we should know that we have understood Bhagavad-gita. By my mental speculation, by Rascal interpretation, by showing one's scholarship, you cannot understand Bhagavad-gita. That is not possible. Submission. Therefore, in the Bhagavad-gita it is said, tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. So, we have to surrender as Arjuna. Surrender. Shishrastiham sadhimam prapannam. I surrender unto you. I become your disciple. To become disciple means to surrender. Voluntarily accepting the instruction, the advice, the order of the spiritual master. So Arjuna has already accepted that. Although he is speaking, the najos, Krishna is not fight. But master, when he explains everything, in fight. Master's order. Not to fight, that is his own sense gratification. And to fight, in spite of, he had no desire to fight, that is the satisfaction of the master. This is the sum and substance of Bhagavad-gita. So, Krishna, seeing Arjuna, Vishidantam, very much affected, lamenting, that he is not prepared to do his duty. Therefore, in the next verse, he begins that asochyan anusuchastang prajnavadamsya bhasas. My dear Arjuna, you are my friend. Never mind, Maya is very strong, despite your being my friend, personal. You are so much overwhelmed with false compassion. So just hear me. Therefore say, asochyan, you are lamenting on a subject matter, which is not at all asochyan. Socha means lamentation. And asocha means one should not lament. Asocha. So asocchanani sutastam prajnavadan subhasis. But you are talking like very learned scholar, because he has talked. But those things are right. What Arjuna has said, that varna sankar, when the women become polluted, the population is varna sankar. That is fact. Whatever Arjuna has said to Krishna, in order to avoid the fighting, those things are correct. But from the spiritual platform, those things may be correct or incorrect, but from spiritual platform they are not to be considered very serious. Therefore, asocchanani sutastha. Because his lamentation was on the bodily concept of life. That bodily concept of life, in the very beginning of Krishna's instruction, it is condemned. Asochan anisuchastam. You are lamenting on the bodily concept of life. Because anyone who is in the bodily concept of life is no better than animal.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.